All right, well, it is the stuff of nightmares. A woman has been viciously attacked by two Irish wolfhounds while walking her dog on a popular track in Sydney, forcing her to flee into neck-deep mud by the Georges River.
The attack lasted a grueling 15 minutes until police finally deterred the dogs with pepper spray. Witnesses Michelle and Ed Rezik, who called the police, join us now. Good morning, guys. Nice to see you this morning. Ed, to you first of all, can you explain what you saw on Sunday morning, how it all unfolded?
Yeah, what it was, we were basically packing up, ready to go. We're here now, the Hunter Valley, and in a normal day, you hear some dogs barking in the background or whatever, and this sounded a little bit more sinister. So once we heard a lady screaming, we jumped down on the balcony and, you know, just all sorts of things looked wrong. Basically tried to call out to her because we could see these dogs just going at her relentlessly. And pretty much, long story short, called the police, yelled out to her, just knowing that she's not there alone, because as you can see, no one is around. And hopefully she just saw the comfort that we had, that once we heard the sirens and the choppers and all that, that, you know, help is coming, and hope she felt some relief and not alone at that point.
Gee, it's terrifying. And she's very lucky that you guys were there to see it all. Michelle, the woman is in hospital with serious injuries. I mean, we hear that you played a crucial role in her survival.
Yeah, look, I just rang the police and we spoke to them and directed them where to go. And basically, like, it was longer than 15 minutes. It was probably 15 minutes from when the time the police got there. But she was down there for at least the 20 minutes beforehand, just fending off those dogs. And they just kept coming and kept coming and kept coming. And, yeah, it was a pretty hard thing to watch, knowing it looks where... She's just right there off the balcony, but we have no way of getting to her. So
we're on the other side of the river.
Other side of the river.
A bit helpless that we felt.
Look, I'm sure, but also what you're saying here is the dogs kept attacking her. I mean, that must have been so frightening for her.
Just kept coming and kept coming, and she was so brave, and she was pushing them away whilst holding her little dog. She had the way she was situated was kind of her back was to us, so we couldn't really see her face, but we can hear her saying get away and pushing the dogs. And
even after being pepper sprayed,
they still
came back. They still just wanted to attack her little dog and didn't want to stop.
What do you think of police and what they were able to do?
They were awesome. They were so good. The guy that actually got stuck in the mud didn't hesitate to go to her and, you know, kind of looked like he was comforting her. And then there was another lady that she came across, and they had a bit of trouble finding her, but they were calling us on the phone and they didn't stop.
Really quick response.
Really quick. They were really good.
See, it's unbelievable. I mean, these other two dogs too. I mean, I don't know what you'd do in that situation.
Well, that's what we were thinking. We're going, this is not normal. And as I said, we couldn't do much, but hopefully just hearing that she wasn't alone, I hope that was comfort enough. And as we said, once the chopper and the siren started, it felt awesome.
All right,
good feeling knowing that help was on its way.
Well, good
and
idea.
As Michelle was saying, that police officer that was sitting with her, he just sat with her chest deep in mud.
Yeah,
and he just waited.
The very best of the police on show yesterday. And you guys,
two
are a couple of cool cats. Well done on what you did. Wish I was up there in the Hunter Valley with you.
That's why the puppies are on.
Yeah, I get it. I get it, brother. I get it.
Very early.
Also, the Hunter Valley can do that to you. Good on you guys.
Thanks for joining us, guys.